I have teached a ton of videos here in this channel about Final Cut Pro, how you can do plenty of effects in Final Cut Pro, and how you can use it for video editing. When I want to edit something on the go, and usually vertical content, the short form content for Instagram Reels, for TikTok, or for YouTube Shorts, the app that I use is CapCut. Recently, I found out that CapCut has also a desktop version. A desktop version which is free, and it's available for Mac and Windows. And what if I told you that after I used it for some weeks, I can tell you for sure that for someone who is just starting out in video editing, someone who wants to create vertical content, short form content, or even more advanced things on their videos, is all they could ask for free. Watch an example. Let's go now into CapCut. We're gonna start from the beginning. I'm gonna show you a lot of different features. It's gonna be a long video, so have your notes, and if you have any questions, I'm waiting you as you watch the video in the comment section down below. Let's go. You open the CapCut and you click on New Project. Now here we can import the videos that we're gonna use by simply click on Import or by dragging them from the window. So I have here the videos that I'm gonna use and the music. The music, by the way, is from Artlist, great source for music. You will find links in the description of this video down below. The first thing that you need to do is to modify the settings of your video. So you click here on Modify, and as you can see, here are the settings. You can select the ratio from original of the videos to 16 to 9, 4 to 3, 235 to 1, 2 to 1, 185 to 1, and also the vertical ones. Then you can have the resolution, the adapted adapts into the video, so you can use the customized if you want to be more precise. And on customize, for a 4K, we will select 3840 and 2160. Frame rate, I'm gonna stick it to 25 frames per second. Here in Europe we have PAL. If you're in Americas, NTSC 24 frames per second. Then you can select the color space if you want to have HDR or SDR, Rec 709, and you click Save. For those of you who have used in the past the program to edit your videos, the timeline basically, it's the same timeline that we see in apps like Final Cut Pro or DaVinci Resolve. It reminds a lot of the magnetic timeline. For this example, we're gonna drag some footage is here. From here, as you can see, I can zoom in and zoom out. And now let me bring the audio, the music as well. One very cool feature that CapCut has is the auto beat. So you go here to auto beat and you can select beat 1, and it automatically recognizes the beats of the music that you have played, so you know exactly where you want to cut the footage. And you have the option for beat 1 or B2. The B2 basically is more beats, more cuts that you can do in your video. Now we're gonna zoom again and we will see that, let's start it here and place it at the beginning. And now as you can see, if I place my footage where the cuts are, automatically it recognizes the beat and it basically it auto cuts for you. And check this out. You saw here that the footage had a little bit of black at the top and at the bottom. So you go here, you just drag this, and as soon as you drag it a little bit to down and right, it automatically goes to the edges, so you don't have to manually adjust everything or press any shift or anything like that. Let me drag this here now to show you something else. Another cool feature that the CapCut desktop version, also the mobile version, but the desktop version has, is the ability to have amazing speed ramps. And let me show you exactly what I mean. So you select this clip, you go here to speed, and you click on curve. You can either select any pre-made, let's say you want to have a bullet, for example, and you will see that it automatically does the bullet speed ramp for you, or you can click on customize and you can select exactly the portions that you want to have. So let's say that from here, to that point here, you want it to be extreme fast, right? So you go here, and also if you click where you want it, let's say here, you can add one more point to make it fast. And here on the beat, let's say that you want to add another key point. You can either select all of them at once if you click on the middle, or you can select each one if you want, because maybe you want to do something like that. Let's continue with the example. So you select this, you go again fast for all of this section, and then you drag this and you make them slow. With this selection, you can do up to 10 times fast and 10 times slow. As you can see, we're creating some speed drums here. Now, if you see any choppiness, what you can do is that you can click on smooth slow-mo, and what are we going to use from this? Either frame blading or optical flow. Usually what we do is use the optical flow, something that also I have shown you in the past for Final Cut Pro. Optical flow is the best option when you want to have the smoothest slow motion. If we go now into the interface to show you a little bit of CapCut, you will see that on the audio section, you have the option to use custom music as well, but also you can sign in into your TikTok account and you can select music directly from TikTok, which means that especially for vertical content, editing the vertical content that you can post in TikTok or Instagram Reels, you can have all this trendy music for your videos. Also, you can import a video. Let's say you download a video from TikTok, you want to have this exact audio, you place it here, the video, and it extracts the audio that you can use for your video. Another cool feature is that you have a variety of sound effects that you can use for your video. Basically, the video that you saw at the beginning, it was edited in CapCut with all the music and sound effects that they are available inside. And something that a lot of content creators use in their everyday process of creating videos is the auto caption. The auto caption is basically when you have a video and the speech is becoming text visualized to you. We've seen that a lot in TikTok, in Instagram, in YouTube short, in all the short form content. And basically, CapCut takes any video, and you can select here the auto captions. It recognizes the speech and create captions for you. Let's see an example, because this is something that you're going to use a lot if you download CapCut. Again, it's free. And when you create short form content, the numbers, the statistics, all the analysis show that when you have text as well, a lot of people don't watch videos with the sound on, so you can show the message that you have on your videos. So you click on create. Okay, so I have this text for you to check. We're clicking on create. If your English is better than mine, the caption is going to be better. Now, if there is any mistake, you can go here and you can correct it. Now, you can select from here the font that you want to use. You can change the color and you can select any of the preset styles that it has. So you can have white background or yellow with black, or this one here. You can change the scale if you want. You can add a stroke or a background. You can choose to create a glow, shadow, etc. You can also download different effects and bubbles as well for your speech to text. And of course, if you want it to be more word by word, you can come here, split it by clicking here, and this is, you keep only this part, and here again, we split it, we select here, disable it, and let's check this out. This is a test video to show the auto captions from CapCut. You can select different animations for your text. As you mouse over, you will see all the available animations for in. For example, you can download the mini zoom. You can have different animations for each of the text that you're going to use. Or you can simply select all of them, go to animation and select one. So all of the texts are going to have the same. So individually or all of them. And then you can also use motion tracking. So you can motion track a specific element if you want to have the captions motion tracked as well. On your video now, you can place stickers, you can have different effects, and the effects that CapCut has right now available, I'm telling you, I have created a ton of tutorials in Final Cut Pro to create a lot of these different effects, and now we have them all available with just one click. I'm not gonna go into each one of them, I'm gonna scroll them just for you to check them out. I'm telling you, there are a lot of effects, so, and if you click in one effect, it's gonna show you exactly how it's gonna look. For example, you can drag this, you can place it here on the footage, and you will see it's very easy and very fast to do. You also have different transitions as all of the video editing programs, and I can tell you that they are very creative. So we can check, for example, this dissolve, and we have the transition right away. Again, I'm gonna scroll a little bit so you can check all the different transitions that it has, and then we go to filters. Just like all the applications, especially on the mobile, that you need to be fast and easy to control all the edits, you have all the effects available on a desktop version of a video editing app. And on the adjustment, you can have custom adjustments, the adjustment layers, for example, or you can use LUT to color grade. CapCut also gives you the option to color correct your footage, and you can go to the adjustment here, and you have all the options with LUT or adjustments to temperature, hue, saturation, as you can see here, brightness, contrast, highlights, sharpen with effects, on the HSL to change the hue of specific colors, the saturation and the brightness, and of course, the beloved to all the video editors, photographers, and people who like to color grade the footage, curves. You also have the option to have different animations on the footage. For example, let's see this shake. Again, you click on that and you mouse over and you see how it's gonna look. And again, as you saw before with the captions, you have the option for motion track as well. Another cool feature is that you can stabilize your shaky footage. And as you can see, the processing is not very slow. It's getting on a decent amount of time for you to stabilize the shot. And something last that I want to mention here is that it also has motion blur. And the good thing is that you can either drag the effect to place it on the actual footage, or you can drag the effect, and if you place it above, it comes as an adjustment layer. That means that if you want to have a motion blur that you can change, of course, the horizontal, the strength, everything on the spec, on the settings, like an inspector panel here on the right, you can add the motion blur just on the transitions, or where you have a speed ramp that you want to have a motion blur as well. A very common trend that we've seen, especially in car stories and car short form content online. When you finish with your edit, when you finish with your video, you go on the top right and you click on export to export the video. From there, you can select the resolution, the bitrate, that you can select from lower, recommended, higher, or customized. Let's say higher because we like the high stuff. The codec, the format of the video, if you want to be MOV or MP4, the frame rate, and you click on export after, of course, you select the name and the location of the export, you click export and the export begins. But also, since CapCut is very connected with TikTok, you can sign into TikTok and you can post right away from CapCut on the desktop version your videos on TikTok. If you're interested to get CapCut, I will have all the links in the description of this video down below. If you like this video, I'm sure that you're gonna like this one as well. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio, and I will see you in the next video. Yahara!